It's very important that Jews be allowed to pray where their mothers and fathers are buried. But now, since 67, we are able to visit, and so my family and I traveled there in August, and my son had an aliyah in the Cave of Machpelah, and we had a wonderful tour, and we got to see firsthand all the wonderful things that are being done in Hebron to restore the community to its former grandeur.
We went to Israel to celebrate our son's Bar Mitzvah, and at the culmination of a fantastic trip, we spent our last day in Hebron. I was amazed and thrilled, really, to see what a vibrant community there is there. There were over 100 people davening in the Cave of Machpelah, where my son had an aliyah as a continuation of his Bar Mitzvah celebration, and people broke into song and dance. And then afterwards, we were taken on a tour to see how the people really lived. And we saw a neighborhood. We saw kids playing, kids riding their bikes. It's really impossible to visit Hebron without being impressed by the commitment and the devotion of the community and really how they've created a regular life under difficult circumstances. We were very impressed.
So it was just a very great thrill to be there, and we felt very inspired. I mean, this is the home of the Jewish people. This is where it all started. This is where it all began. So this is really one of the holiest places for the Jewish people, a place that every Jewish person should visit when they come to Israel, and we are very privileged to visit it.
What I've learned from my parents' love of Israel, and specifically Hebron, is that I also need to have a great love of Israel and Hebron. Some places in Israel, specifically Hebron, and they really need our help. And that's why the Hebron Fund is so important.
Also like to say how proud we are of Jay and Robbie, my husband and my son, dad and brother, for receiving this honor. It's so important to stand behind your ideals and work hard on behalf of them.
We need to be strong. There are people in Israel that want to give all these things back, or they say give it to the Palestinians, and we know if we do that, we'll never be able to visit our mothers and fathers again. So it would really be a great shame. We need to keep it in Jewish hands. And I want to thank the 1,000 beautiful Jewish people who live in Hebron. It's a very difficult life to live there, but yet they live there. And because they live there, that's why we have access to these holy sites. And for me and my family to be involved is a really great privilege.
Thank you for coming and have a great night.